Mr. Bentley has a special job for us to do in the country.
Who do you need to help you, Bob?
Well, right now, you, Rolly, and Dizzy. Muck and Lofty can bring the building materials later.
Okay, team, can we fix it?
Yes, we can!
Yeah, I think so.
Hello, Bob. You're nice and early, as always.
I like your hat, Mr. Bentley.
Thank you very much, Dizzy.
What is this place, Mr. Bentley?
This is a nature reserve. Bob and I are members of the Birdwatching Club, and all this land belongs to them.
Mr. Bentley wants us to build a blind. It's a small hut where we can sit when we want to watch different kinds of birds.
And there's a bird you don't see very often called the lesser-spotted grebe warbler. It's due to pass by here on its way south.
Why is it flying south?
Some birds migrate. That means when the weather gets cold, they fly away to a warmer part of the world.
Now, I don't want you to think of me as a building inspector today. I'll just go and keep my eyes open for the warbler.
Come on, you three. We have to clear this ground before we can build anything.
Mr. Bentley? Mr. Bentley!
Oh, sorry, Spud. I didn't notice you there.
I've never seen that hat before.
Well, I only wear it when I'm out bird watching.
Bird watching? Cool! Want me to scare them, Mr. Bentley? Then you can watch them fly away!
No, no, Spud. This is a nature reserve. You're not allowed to scare birds here.
But I'm a scarecrow. That's my job.
No, Spud. If you want to come into the nature reserve, you have to promise not to scare any birds at all.
Well, okay, Mr. Bentley.
Then you can come in.
If I can't scare birds, what can I scare?
Dizzy, what does a lesser-spotted thing look like?
I think it looks like a giant pink ostrich.
Yeah, or maybe it's more like an enormous parrot.
Yeah, well, it must be really big and scary looking.
Why's that?
Well, Bob's building a bird blind. It must be pretty scary if Bob's gonna hide from it.
Maybe it has really big claws and a giant pointy beak. I think I'll see how Bob's doing.
Oh, wait for me!
Now I know who I can scare, and I know just how to do it.
Good work, team. Now that the foundation is done, you can go back to the yard.
Okay, Bob.
Bye, Bob.
Hello, Bob's building yard.
Oh, Pilchard.
Is the filing almost finished, Wendy?
Well, it would be if Pilchard wasn't trying to help. Do you want Muck and Lofty to come over now?
That'd be great, Wendy.
Okay, Bob. I'll go get them.
Hi!
Hello!
Hello!
Oh, hi!
Hello, Bob! Look! We brought the parts you need to make the blind!
Oh, no! There's a hole in the wall!
That's so we can see the birds when we're in the blind.
Oh, I thought that's what it was.
Oh, Spud, you are so smart. If you can't scare birds, you can still scare the machines. And what are the machines most scared of? The lesser spotted Spud Warbler. What was that? Maybe it's the real grebe warbler. Don't worry, Spud. There's no bird that you can't scare. Yeah!
Boo! Hello, Spud. What's the matter? Did you step on some thorns? Oh, never mind. I can't see any more around here anyway.
I was just, practicing my bird calls.
Well, I'm glad you're interested in bird watching.
Hey, Bob! Can't we paint the blind a really bright color?
Like blue!
She can't have a blue blind. No one's supposed to notice it.
That's right, Scoop. That's why it's brown and green, so it blends in with all these plants.
Oh, I get it. That way, the birds won't see you when you're watching them.
Yes, Muck. It's called
camouflage.
Is that why Mr. Bentley has all those twigs on his hat?
Exactly, Scoop. That's another kind of camouflage.
Bob! Bob! I've spotted the lesser spotted grebe warbler.
Quick! Inside the blind, Mr. Bentley!
Oh, yes.
Oh, help! The big scary grebe warbler's coming! Oh,
what are we gonna do?
I know. Let's camouflage ourselves.
Aha! A pine cone!
This'll really scare those machines.
It's tickle!
Shh! Do you hear something?
Oh no! It's the grebe warbler!
No, it's not. It's Spud. Look at his nose.
What? What's that noise?
Where are those voices coming from?
Poor Spud.
I'm surrounded. Help!
Finally, I got away from those scary voices. It's only a little bird. Go on, shoo! Oh, shoo, will you? Oh, why give up? I can't even scare a little bird. I'm going home. Oh, do you want to come too? I'm sure this is the right way, little warbler.
Oh my, what's that? Oh, it's just Spud again.
Oh, where am I?
Don't believe it! Spud's found the lesser spotted grebe warbler!
It's those scary voices again! Help!
He's going to scare the warbler away! Oh no, oh no!
Don't worry, Spud. It's just us.
Oh, Bob, where did you come from?
We've been inside the blind.
And we were camouflaged, so you couldn't see us.
You found a very rare bird, Spud.
But why were we hiding from the warbler? It's not scary.
We were in the blind, so we wouldn't scare the bird, Muck. Not the other way around.
Oh, I get it.
I just want to get a couple of photos. Okay, let me adjust the focus and... Oh no!
Spud, see if you can get him to come down.
He thinks you're another bird!
All right, but don't blame me if I scare him away. I am a scarecrow, remember?
Oh my goodness, how beautiful.
Are you gonna sing another song?
I think it's time for him to go, Spud.
Oh, bye-bye. I'm really gonna miss him.
He'll be back next year, Spud.
Spud, you've changed from a bird scarer to a champion bird watcher in one day. I think you deserve these.
Oh, thanks, Mr. Bentley. They're terrific. Well, back to the farm.
Bob, should we tell Spud to take off his bird costume?
Oh, I'm sure he'll remember, Scoop. Eventually.
Ah!